pants off.
When somebody asks you how much they are, say one for a nickel and two for a dime.
One for a nickel and two for a dime.
Very good. Go try again.
No, no, no.
Pencil.
Are you selling pencils?
One for a nickel and two for a dime.
Are they sharp?
Pencil!
You should say some of them are and some of them aren't.
Some of them are and some of them aren't.
Very good. Go try it again.
Normal kind, not the kind where you have to add sugar.
Sugar! You know what they say, once you had black, you'll never go back.
Bill!
Saw it on one of those talk shows. You know, I just work with the weirdest guy. You know, it's like, whenever he goes on his coffee break, right, he carefully pours in his coffee, carefully pours in his cream, and then puts in exactly 3 spoonfuls of salt.
Sugar!
No, I said salt.
You salt? No, I need sugar! Sugar, you! Sugar, I tell you, I need sugar! Sugar!
Rip my heart right out of my rib cage with my bare hands and then throw it on the floor and start. She is right. He was really hot.
You can say that again.
The spicy girls?
I'm tarragon.
I'm cinnamon.
I'm oregano.
I'm parsley.
And I'm Old Spice.
And we're the spicy girls. You're not to be confused with the spice girls.
We're much better singers
and much better looking.
Just listen.
Thank you.
I gotta give snacks to Regan.
I think we should say we all did good.
Yeah, girl power.
Girl power!
Love it.
Hello? You want to give me my own record yet?
Yeah, sure.
Screw those others.
Yes, that's right.
Oh,
that's
about
that.
Oh,
Novak.
Yes, that's right. Sorry, I tested the letter B. Yes, that's right. It's all due to trauma I suffered as a schoolboy. I was attacked by a Siamese bat.
Bat?
No, a bat. Oh, yeah. Car key, pine, kettle, kipper, keyweight, cubable inch Oxford. What spelled color with a K?
Yeah.
Color. Oh, thank you. I never thought of that. What a silly one. Yes, I've been on package tours many times, so you ever really bought my eye. So, yeah, it did. You were great. Fantastic. Really bought my eye. Yes, you're quite right. You know, I'm fed up with being treated like a sheep. I mean, what's the point of going abroad if you're just another tourist, crowded around in buses, surrounded by sweaty, mindless oafs from Regina and Saskatoon, with their cloth caps and their cardigans and their transistor radios complaining about the tea. Oh, they don't make it properly here, do they? Not like at home. Stopping up at George Medina, selling fish and chips in Watney's Red Barrel and calamars and tuna fish. Sitting in their cotton sun frocks, squirting Timothy White sun cream all over their puffy, raw, swollen, pearl and flesh, because they overdid it on the first day. And being herded into Wellness Hotel Miramar's, and vomiting tiles of the modern international luxury roomettes, and draft Red Barrel and swimming pools full of fat German businessmen pretending they're acrobats, forming pyramids and frightening the children and barging in the queues. And if you're not at your table from 1 to 7, you must have all of Campbell's cream of mushroom soup, the first item on the menu of international cuisine. And every night at the hotel and the bar has a bloody cabaret featuring a tiny emaciated dago with 9-inch hips and some bloated fat tart where there are both creams down in a big ass presenting flamenco performers. And every night at the from Birmingham with third class legs and diarrhea picking up every wet thing from Regina. And every week there's a local ruin excursion to buy cherry and ice cream and Watney's Red Barrel. You go to a typical restaurant with local color and atmosphere, and you sit next to a party from Gravelbourg, you keep singing, Torrey Malina, Torrey Malina. I'm complaining about the food, it's so greasy here, isn't it? And you get cornered by some drunken greengrocer from Regina with Dr. Skull sandals and Tuesday's Daily Express, and he drums on and on and on about how especially running this country, how many language he knocked out and speaking, and throws up all over the keyboard. And then sending kids and postcards to places they don't realize they haven't visited, to all at number 22, where the wonderful our room is marked with an X. Very greasy, but we found a charming little place hidden away in the back streets where they serve cheese and onions and bleeding Watney's Red Barrel and
the trek on the narrow way with a half-crazed Mississippi twirl. Another famous
by the Renaissance Theatre Group. My name is Annette Luciak, and I'll be your MC tonight, having been upgraded from co-host. Our first performance tonight is from a very special woman. She is coming back to us tonight after having such a good time last time. So let's sit back and give a warm welcome to Martha Stewart.
Give it up for Hank. couldn't make it, so I'm Franklin's brother. I don't know if you know Franklin, he's like this big nerd. So I'm going to tell you about my family and our family vacation. Well, I had 2 weeks of vacation time coming after working all year down at Big Roy's Heating and Plumbing. So one night when my family and I were gathered around the dinner table, I said, kids, if you could go anywhere in this great big world now, where'd you like to go to? They said, Dad, we want to see the biggest ball of twine in Minnesota. They picked the biggest ball of twine in Minnesota. So the very next day we loaded up the car with potato skins and pickled wieners, crossword puzzles, Spider-Man comics, and Mama's homemade rhubarb pie. Pulled out of the driveway and the neighbors, they all waved goodbye. And so began our 3-day journey. We picked up a guy holding a sign that said, twine ball or bust. He smelled real bad and he said his name was Jeremy. I put in a Slim Whitman tape, my wife put on a brand new hairnet. Kids were in the backseat, jumping up and down, yelling, are we there yet? And all of us were joined together in one common thought as we rolled down the long and winding interstate on 53 to Soda. On our way to see the biggest ball of twine in Minnesota. We're heading for the biggest ball of twine in Minnesota. Well, we couldn't wait to get there, so we drove straight through for 3 whole days and nights. Of course, a stop for more pickled wieners now and then. The scenery was just so pretty, both sides of the car, because the windows are completely covered in the decals from all the places where we've already been. Like Elvis Arama, the Tupperware Museum, the Bull Weevil Monument, Cranberry World, the Shuffleboard Hall of Fame, Pool Dog Rock, and a Michelob Albino Squirrels. We've been to Ghost Town, Steam Parks, Wax Museums, and a place where you could drive through the middle of a tree scene. Alligator Farms, a Tarantula Ranch, but there's still one place we gotta see. Well, we crossed the state line about 6:39, and we saw the sign that said Twine Ball Exit 50 miles. Well, the kids were so happy they started singing 99 bottles of beer on the wall for the 27th time that day. So we pulled up the road to the last chance gas station, got a few more pickled wieners and a diet chocolate soda. On our way to see the biggest ball of twine in Minnesota. We're heading for the biggest ball of twine in Minnesota. Finally, at 7:37 early Wednesday evening, as the sun was setting in the Minnesota sky, out in the distance, on the horizon, it appeared to me like a vision before my unbelieving eyes. We parked the car and walked with awe-filled reverence toward that glorious, huge, majestic sphere. Just so overwhelmed by its sheer immensity, I had to pop myself a beer. Yes, on these hallowed grounds, open 10 to 8 on weekdays, in a little shrine under a makeshift pagoda, there sits the biggest ball of twine in Minnesota. Sell you the biggest ball of twine in Minnesota. That kind of thing. Whoa, winding up 21,140 pounds of string. What was he trying to prove? Who was he trying to impress? Why did he build it? How did he do it? Is anybody's guess? Where did he get the twine? What was going through his mind? Did it just seem like a good idea at the time? Well, we walked up beside it and I warned the kids, now you better not touch those ropes, are there for a reason? I said, maybe if you're good, I'll tie it to the back of our car and maybe take it home, but I was only teasing. Then we went to the gift shop. shop and stood in line. Bought a souvenir miniature and ball of twine, some window decals, and anything else they'd sell us. Then I bought a couple postcards, greetings from the twine ball, wish you were here, won't the folks back home be jealous. I gave her camera to Jeremy, we stood by the ball, and we all gathered around and said, geez. Then Jeremy ran away with my friend who was thematic, but at least we got our memories. So we all just stared at the ball for a while, then my eyes got moist, but I said with a smile, kid, this here's what America's all about. Then I started feeling kind of gooey inside, and I fell on my knees, and I cried and cried, and that's when those security guards threw us out. You know I've been all around this big roll on the way down to Fargo, North Dakota, 'cause it's the biggest ball of twine in Minnesota. And I tell you, it's the biggest ball of twine in Minnesota. But we stayed that night at the twine ball, and in the morning we were on our way home again, but we didn't really want to leave, that was perfectly clear. I said, folks, I can tell you're all sad to go. Then I winked my eye and I said, you know, I got a funny kind of feeling we'll be coming back again next year. Because I've been all around this great big world and I can't think of anywhere else I'd rather go to than the biggest ball of twine in Minnesota. I tell you, the biggest ball of twine in Minnesota.
This next sketch involves a park and a man in a park. This man sings, so therefore he's the singing guy. He's the singing guy in a park. That is the sketch. The name of the sketch is the singing guy brackets in a park, but don't put the brackets if you're going to write it. Just put singing guy. You kind of know that he's in a park, now that I've told you that he's now the singing guy in a park. So in conclusion, to summarize, this next sketch involves a man singing in a park. Thank you.
Mighty fine park you guys have here. Birdies, bunny, and plants. Lots of plants. I'm gonna sit and sing. And I'm singing that in the park. My lunch. Oh, we got the lunch for you. This is a mighty awfully nice park you have. Such a pretty park. This is such a pretty park. Well, you know what I noticed? I noticed there's no people here. Just me, singing guy. Maybe there could be a girl. Hey, little girl, I see you walking by me. I see you walking by me. Do you have any money? There's a girl in the park and she's got some money for me. Yeah. What are you doing? Get away, guy! Holy cow. You think she'd think I was begging? This is my lunch. It's my lunch, man. I wish I had some friends.
Hey, man.
I wish I had me some friends.
I'm
going
to sing and listen to you for a little while, okay? That's awesome. Keep singing, man. Keep going. It's cool. Groovy. Keep it up.
Please bring me some friends.
No. I like your song, man. I like your song. Just keep singing.
Just any old friend.
I'm telling you, man. Come on.
Why you go away? Go away! I don't want you here. Go away!
Okay.
Maybe another friend.
that guy was really weird. Like a bunny.
Wait,
who's
that?
Oh, hey, hey, hard-headed woman, soft-hearted man.
Doesn't work.
Love me tender, love me true, never
bad now.
Bring me a friend. I need some friends.
Cause it's an ugly big park and I'm so lonely.
So very lonely. I'm so lonely. I really hope they don't talk to me. I hope they really don't talk to me. I hope they really don't talk. You're crowding me! You're crowding me!
Why don't people just leave me alone? I just want to play music and have my lunch. Anybody want a banana?
Out of Red Leicester today.
Never mind. How do you want to?
Well, at the end of the week, it's kind of hard to come by. It comes fresh on Mondays.
No matter. Well, sit down with Yum and 4 ounces of confibulator, please.
Yes, that was on order since 2 weeks ago. I was expecting it this morning.
It's not my lucky day, is it? Belpay, is it?
Sorry, sir.
Red Windsor?
Normally, yes. Today, the truck broke down.
Vimental?
No.
Grigo?
No.
Any Norwegian Carlsberg?
No.
Lipta?
No.
Langeshow?
No.
Danish Blue?
No.
Double Boston?
No.
Brie?
No.
Rockefeller, Polybeck, Polsanu, Semoyan, Sephora, Ferretales, Westbrook, Warsaw?
No.
Any Norwegian Jarlsberg?
No.
How about Camembert?
Camembert, yes, Camembert, we have some of that.
You do, excellent.
Yes, I'm afraid it's a wee bit runny, though.
Oh, sir. I like it runny.
No, I'm afraid it's a very runny thing.
No matter. Fetch him another fromage de la défense.
I think it's a little bit more runnier than you would like.
I don't care how dang runny it is. Hand it over with all speed.
Oh.
What now?
The cat just ate.
That's good.
Sheep, sir.
Gouda?
No.
Edam?
No.
Casey Ness?
No.
Smoke Austrian?
No.
Japanese Sage Darby?
No.
You do have some cheese, do you?
Well, of course, this is a cheese shop, but we have...
No, don't tell me. I'll keep the guess.
Sir.
When's the day?
Yes.
Well, I'll have some of that.
Oh, I thought you were talking to me. Mr. Wensendale, that's my name.
Greek feta?
No.
Gorgonzola?
No.
Parmesan?
Sorry, sir.
Mozzarella?
Not any of that.
Pepper creamer?
No.
Danish himbo?
Sorry.
Czech sheep's milk?
No.
Venezuelan beaver cheese?
None of that, please.
How about the cheddar?
Nah, there's not much need for cheddar around here.
Not much need? It's the single most popular cheese in the world!
Not around these parts, sir.
What is the most popular cheese around these parts?
Ilchester, sir.
Is it?
Yes, it is. It's staggeringly the most popular cheese in this RM.
Is it?
Yes, it's our number one bestseller.
All right. Okay, Ilchester.
Ilchester, correct.
Have you got any? I wasn't expecting the answer there.
No.
Some of the cheese shop, is it?
Oh, it's the finest in the district.
Explain my logic underlying my conclusion.
Well, look how clean it is, sir.
It's certainly contaminated by cheese.
You didn't ask me about liver, did it, sir?
Want to be well?
Certainly.
Have you shut that bloody Jamaican off?
Oh, yes, sir.
Have you got any from the door?
No.
I guess. Predictable, really, I suppose. It was an act of purest optimism to oppose a question in the first place.
Stop it!
Have you, in fact, got any cheese here at all?
Yes, sir.
Really?
No, not really, sir.
You have?
Not a scrap. I was just deliberately wasting your time, sir.
Well, I'm sorry, but I'm going to have to hit you in the face with a pop.
Radio, then.
What a senseless waste of whipped cream.
Questions?
Okay.
The
pie
tasted
awful
and
Hank
threw it
to
my
face
hard.
It
really
hurt.
Why is the sky blue?
Obviously,
the
sky
is
blue
because
the
atmosphere
is
screwed. We
love
to
explain
your
questions
because
we
know
the
answer
to
them.
Yeah.
Why did you poop on the board?
I am
really
clumsy and
I
like
to
stumble a lot.
I really
didn't
mean
to. The end. The end.
This is great, isn't it? I should be an actress or something. 90210, here I come. 7th Heaven. What do you think about the radio? Should I be on the radio? Hello, radio, yeah. Radiohead. But I don't think I can sing. I'll have to leave the singing up to professionals, so here's another song.
Tell me when not to blow, 'cause
intermission, if you want to get yourself some drinks or some snacks at the concession, you better be back here. Welcome back, everybody.
Woo!
Nice to see I haven't scared all of you away. That's good. Only a few missing. I've got some more jokes for you tonight. Okay. But first, Jeremy and Hank.
Yo, Jamie, how's it going? We got an MC coming here.
You are.
a fly chick. So on the stage.
Yo, she's a fly chick, that's right.
I call her Brian.
Yo, very cool, man, very cool.
Yo. Jeez. I got those jokes, I promise. I'm serious. Why do fish swim in salt water? Because pepper makes them sneeze. Okay, I guess I'm not a comedian. I'm blonde, I can't remember the jokes. And if I can remember them, I don't understand them. Why was 6 afraid of 7? 7, 8, 9, that's right. And what did the fish say when he hit a wall? Damn. But here, we go again.
Hi, everybody. This is an improv that we're doing again, but this time we need two volunteers from the audience. Anybody? Anybody? Okay, there's one right over there. How about I go get her? Some volunteers. Let's see.
Okay, how about you right here?
Yeah, come on. You know you want it. Come on. There we go. Okay.
I think Vicky put her hand up. I think Vicky did.
How about you right there? Come on. Now, this is, you've probably seen on Whose Life Is It Anyway, it's Mannequins. What it is she will be moving Jeremy, and Vicky will be moving me, and we have to have a scene. We're proposing a scene, so name a place, any place.
McDonald's
in Paris.
Okay, McDonald's in Paris. And we need a job.
What?
A job, any job.
Busboy.
Okay.
Busboy, yes, because McDonald's is in Paris.
Yes, right. We need a busboy.
We are
okay.
Bus people.
So, and what your jobs are to just move us. You know how to do that?
Okay. Because if we can't move.
Great.
Unless you
okay. Hey, Jacques.
Hey, Pepe.
I have no French accent.
Well, that is okay. I have a cigarette in my hand.
I see.
Because these stupid American tourists smoke in my shop.
McDonald's.
They shop in my McDonald's and they smoke. They smoke all the time.
That's right. We smoke with the quarter pounders. That is what we do.
We get rid of it.
That's right.
I got the lucky knee.
I do not know. I am just standing here, you know. I thought that maybe I should go over there and tell you about this new cigarette that I have in this McDonald's. Do you see this cigarette?
Yes,
you see it right here?
It's in my breast pocket.
Okay.
Yes.
So, you're very good.
Quite nice.
You're a good cigarette.
You know,
I'll try that.
We are kind of wasting quality work time here.
But we are French, we can do anything.
But we should be working at Busboys and McDonald's.
Because the people need quarter pounders
over
there.
Come to us before
right.
We are on our break.
Right. Okay, come
we
on, people.
Ask you to come to us today.
Right.
We will
come
not go
here.
To you. This is
come
a new kind of busing.
Come over here.
A new kind of busing.
Right. Instead of us coming to you, you come to us.
To us.
How
Pepe.
That? To us.
Pepe.
That's right.
Come to Pepe.
Come to me right
come
here.
Come to Pierre. Come to me. I am lonely for people. I am looking for love.
But I love you, Pepe.
I kind of love you too, Pepe.
That is good.
Pepe.
That is so good.
Is this a nod in McDonald's?
No, it is not. No, it is not, Pepe.
Could we get fired?
I think we shall. That's why we need to stay at arm's distance away from each other.
Arm's distance.
That's right. It's about this far. But it's okay. Maybe
I was caught with fishing in the big lake. I caught the fish.
While
I was fishing, I was pulling for the
biggest
fillet of fish.
I cannot believe it. I just can't believe how
the croissant
was that fish. Oh my
and my goodness, I said, look, it's going to rain. I must catch a fish real quickly.
Rain is
because the thunderclouds are coming, and I need to have my coulée.
What is it?
What are you talking about?
A big poisson!
Oh.
And I said, whoa, poisson!
We love the croissants here. We love to eat.
I said poisson. I don't catch no poissons in the ocean.
No, I thought you were just a little crazy, Pepe.
Oh, yes, Pepe is a little...
I want to stop my wrists are very limp because that is how I hold my wrists all the time. French are not very strong people. We can't hold our wrists up. There we go. Okay, you see this? You see, I can barely do this. Because I don't even know how I got the job as a busboy. Because
you don't
I can't
even move. You don't even move.
No. I think it's very statuesque. To just stand here.
I'm
like
taking a break now, Pepe. I'm just taking a break from my heart being a bus boy.
I am.
Pepe, do these jeans look nice on me?
Yes. Oh, wow. Those jeans right there, they look great. They look amazing.
I think I spoiled them. I got a little bit of whipping cream on them. I moved my head.
Well, what about these pants right here? I got some Vesey gap.
I think you wasted your money.
Oh, I'll tell you. Sorry, Le Bleu. You have insulted me.
Well, I'm scared of you. I will run away. I'm scared of Pepe. Oh, Pepe. Hold your distance, Pepe. Oh, it's windy out here, Pepe.
Don't worry. I will get there to beat you up. But I have a stand here. But okay, here I go. I'm moving to beat you up very slowly. Yeah, I'm moving.
You're
watch out.
You're asking for trouble.
Man, we'll beat you up.
Oh, go ahead, Lippy boy. Lippy boy.
Oh, ow. You are hurting me. Stop it. How can I do that? Oh, there you are. Beating you up. There we go. Okay, Lippy, I think we need to leave now. What happened to our Frenchie?
Hello, Grimace.
Ah,
hello.
I have beat them up.
Hello,
I am
Grimace.
The winner.
How many people here have traveled across Canada? Many? Well, I was just in northern BC not very long ago, and I met these people that I really thought you guys had to meet. They are the greatest people in the entire world, and I brought them all the way from northern BC, the Lumberjacks.
I never wanted to be here tonight. I didn't want to do no stinking nights of stinking skits. I didn't want any piece of this. I wanted to do something else. But I really, really, really wanted to be was to be a lumberjack. Skipping down the trees on the mighty rivers of British Columbia with my best girl at my side. The larch, the pine, the giant sequoia, the redwood, the little limpy mule tree. And we'd sing, oh yes, we would sing, oh, I'm a lumberjack and I'm okay. I sleep all night and I work all day. I'm a lumberjack and that's okay. Sleeps all night and I work all day. Cut down trees, I eat my lunch, I go to the lavatory. On Wednesdays I go shopping and have buttered scones for tea.
He cuts down trees, he eats his lunch, he goes to the lavatory. On Wednesdays he goes shopping and has buttered scones for tea.
I'm a lumberjack and I'm okay. I sleep all night and I work all day. I cut down trees, I skip and jump. I like to press wildflowers. I put on women's clothing and hang around in bars.
Cuts down trees, he skips and jumps. He likes to press wildflowers. He puts on women's clothing and hangs around in bars.
I'm a lumberjack and I'm okay. I sleep all night and I work all day. I'm a lumberjack and I'm okay. I sleep all night and I work all day. I cut down trees, I wear high heels, suspenders, and a bra.
I want to be a girly, just like my dear papa.
Cuts down trees, to wear high heels, suspenders, and a bra.
I'm a lumberjack and I'm okay. I sleep all night and I work all day. I'm a lumberjack and I'm okay. I sleep all night and I work all day.
And I thought you were such a rugged man. That wasn't what I had in mind when I invited them here to Gravelbourg. I didn't know who was a girl for you. But we have another skit for you. Are you enjoying yourselves? I can't hear you! I said, another skit.
I got a public service announcement for all of you guys. It's serious, so please listen up. There's been very, very bad string of events that's happening here at the theater tonight. So listen up. There's been many numerous things disappearing, thieving, I think, and there's been some theft. And we are really concerned about this because we're actually quite embarrassed about it. I think we believe it's actually members of Renaissance Renegade Theatre Company. What we've done for you guys is we are quite scared of your own safety. We don't want you guys leaving tonight with any bad feelings or any lost jewelry. So please, we put together a little video clip of may help you avoid such situations that could arise. So please watch this video carefully and you'll watch real pickpocketers at work, okay?
Did you see it? Did you see that? I understand if you didn't see it because you're not a trained professional. You couldn't have really seen it at that speed. That's why we decided to slow it down a tad for the regular Joe, you know, so that you can see it, so you can really learn. Watch out for pickpockers tonight. It could happen. We'll slow it down 10 times. You see that? A blatant pickpocket right on the stage. Could happen to you tonight. That's why you must be careful. Heed my warnings when we show you these video clips, because you must always be careful. Do not trust these people up here. These are professional thieves. They will steal from you. We are gonna slow it down 100 times. Because it's worse than just a random wallet. It's far worse than that. Could happen to you. Please observe.
Veggie Tales.
Did I warn you? Yes, I warned you. I did warn you. Come back. That is my warning. Be careful tonight as you leave. It could happen to you. We're not done yet. Yes! We've decided to slow it down 1,000 times for you! This is a blatant horror and despicable acts of the Renaissance Renegade Theatre Company! We're doing this for your own protection! attention. So please, please observe carefully with your eyes. I don't want anyone scared. Please, please, please observe 1,000 times. Let's go.
Veggie Tales once again.
John, talking John.
decided that stand-up comedy is not my calling.
So I'm here to tell a couple jokes. Okay, what do you call spiders that have just gotten married? Newlyweds. Get it, newlyweds? Okay, here's one of my favorites. Okay, there are these three strings, okay? And they're just ordinary string. Just stringing to your feet. And they're walking around. So these three strings, they go into a bar. And they're pretty thirsty because they've been walking all day. And the one guy goes up to the bar and says, "Bartender, I'd like three drinks for me and my friends." And the bartender looks at him and says, "You're a string, aren't you?" He's like, "Yeah." He's like, "Well, I'm sorry, we don't serve strings here." "Oh, okay." So he goes back to his table, talks to the other guys. He's like, "Sorry guys, we can't get drinks." So the second guy, he's like, "You know, you didn't do it right. You gotta go up macho." So, you know, he slicks his hair back and he puts on a leather jacket and he goes up, "Bartender, I'd like three drinks for me and my friends." And this guy is like, "You're a string too, aren't you?" He's like, "Yeah. Sorry, we don't serve strings here." So the string goes back to his table and he's a little disappointed. The third guy's like, "You know, you didn't do it right." And thinks for a little while and messes up his hair and ties himself in two and walks up to the bartender and says, "Bartender, I'd like three drinks for me and my friends over there." And the guy's like, "You're a string, aren't you?" And the guy's like, "Pray not."
That was good. And now I guess we have an improv sketch by Jeremy, Hank, and Mike.
Okay, well I guess for this one, it's called the Word Improv Game. And I don't know if you've seen it on TV or not, but it starts out, we need three words from the audience. And each word will be for each person. So, any words you can think of, appropriate, of course.
Yes. Scary.
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 Okay.
Scary is Jeremy.
Scary.
All right. Two more.
Spaghetti.
Okay, all be spaghetti.
Barney.
What's that?
Barney.
Okay.
Okay.
Barney. Okay. So now we need, for this sketch, whenever the person's word is said, they either have to come on stage or go off stage. Whether, like, if they're on stage and the word is said, then they have to leave. But if they're off stage and the word is said, they have to come back on. So now we need a scene. Anybody for a scene?
Sauna.
And a sauna, okay? Sauna. Yeah, I guess that's all. Okay.
Sorta, I guess. What's your favorite book?
Farmer's Guide to Sowing Seeds.
The Farmer what?
Guide to Sowing Seeds.
Who would write that kind of book?
Old MacDonald.
Old MacDonald? What the heck's it about?
It's like how they have to take a squatter, or a seeder, and hook it up to a tractor, and they go and drive the field. I read it to my little sister all the time.
Well, there's a great book for you, I mean.
It is.
And where would you get a book like that?
Oh, the new bookstore in Gravelbourg.
There's a bookstore in Gravelbourg?
You mean you haven't, like, heard of it?
No. Where is it?
It's like, in town someplace. I don't remember where.
Oh, well, who runs it?
I don't know. We might meet the bookstore people.
Okay.
All right.
Now, buy it!
I have no money!
I'll take an appointment.
I don't need any money.
I'll take a checkbook. I'll take a bank account.
I don't make it.
Right! I'll buy it for you! There you are! There's no change! There's no money! There's no money! What?
I can't read.
You can't read. Right! Sit down! Sit down! Are you sitting comfortably? Right! Ellen the Aardvark was hoping through the river, trotty, when she spotted a nice quality surveyor!
Go by that bookstore and pick up my copy. How to tell cedars from thrashers, I guess. I'd like to take all the credit here tonight, I mean, MC, but there's a lot of actors and actresses that put this together, so come on out, everybody.
Everybody for coming. I'm Hank Lethbridge, if you didn't know, and I guess I directed this evening's production, but yes, we're going to we had one last month, and then we had one this month, and we're actually going to slow down the productions, and our next production is going to be in the fall, actually. We're going to have the big murder mystery production, and I hope you'll all turn out for that. Right, well, I guess that's all. No? You want me to go on talking? I can't go on talking. I just talk. I mean, I don't understand. People want me to talk. I just don't understand. Talking? Talking? I mean, all I do is stand up here.
Okay, fine.
I'll just talk on this one. So you know, I really like this. This is fun.
I have an important announcement to make.
They're not going to steal one again.
No.
Fine.
That joke was over. It was killed.
Okay.
1,000 times had to kill
okay.
That joke.
Do your little announcement.
Okay, thank you for coming tonight to the theater. I'm here to tell you about another event in a couple of days, the Louise Rose concert. That's right, Louise Rose. She's coming back on Saturday night. That's this Saturday, June 2nd, for another anniversary celebration. You want to know about Louise Rose? I'll tell you about Louise Rose. We're here to say
she's on her way
this Saturday.
Louise Rose concert.
All right. Tickets are only $25, $15 for students. It's going to be another beautiful night here, so we just want to have another fun night here in the theater. Let's use this place as much as we possibly can. So thank you so much for coming tonight. Louise Rose on Saturday, Josie and the Pussycats tomorrow night and Sunday night. Thank you very much. Bye-bye.
Thank you.
Thank you.